Alright, Shalom Akim. Before I get started with this lesson, I want to give all praises, honor, and the glory to Yahawah, Bahashem, Yahawashi, Bahashem, Marakakwedash. And of course, as always, double honors to our apostles and our elders that rule well at Great Millstone. Salutations to all you sincere Akim that are preaching this word in all truth and sincerity. So this is an article, that was put together by Politico.com. And the headline reads, Billionaire-backed plan for new California city gets its debut. The project long shrouded in secrecy, Slovakia. The project, long shrouded in secrecy, could grow to 400,000 people, but would require voter approval first. Now, this is the pride of this damn devil Esau, the so-called white man. All right, here it is. He's got all kinds of things taking place, okay? And he continues on to build up in his empire, all right, thinking, you know, without any fear, man, as if there's no repercussions, man. Okay, it says California Forever says it will be able to buy sufficient water for the project and pay its required share to widen the state highways to provide the only access to the area. Man, you could just read the article for yourself. Alright? But this is the pride of this devil. Okay? Let's get these scriptures. This is Psalm 49:11. Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever. And this devil actually believes that he's going to find a loophole through the scriptures. Alright, you got bug outs out there that actually believe this devil has a time machine to where he could fucking travel through time and be able to repeat, keep us in a Euroboros cycle. Which, that's bugged out, man. Yahawah Bashim Yahushai controls everything. Yahawah Bashim Yahushai controls time. You remember when Jake was fighting, alright, and Joshua, with Joshua, and they held the sun still. Okay, the sun, time stood still, so Jake could have a bigger pillage, alright, of their enemies, man. But that's the pride of Esau, the so-called white man, the damn devil. Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever. That he's never going to be taken out of power. Okay, that he's going to continue on to rule forever and have all these nations in Jacob's subjection. Okay, that they're going to colonize the stars. All right, that they're going to be out there in different galaxies and, you know, multiverses, and them able to build up, you know, expand their empire throughout the cosmos. That's bullshit, man. Okay? It says, and their dwelling places to all generations. They call their lands after their own names. And that's exactly what Esau does. When he goes and he conquers a nation, a country, okay, he puts his flag down and he starts renaming the towns, okay? Renaming the states and land masses, the rivers, all right? How do you think America got its name? Okay, America got its name through when Esau conquered this place and named it after an Italian navigator whose name was Amerigo Vespucci, okay? That's true history. You can look it up. All right? You got different towns and cities named after their generals. And, you know, every highway on these interstates and freeways, you look at the highways, you know, they'll have a little sign. And it'll be like this highway is in memory of this Edomite. And it'll have his name that they dedicated it to. Some Edomite that passed away or sponsored money to build, or, you know, they call their lands after their own names. The place they conquered, man. Okay? This land was called, you know, different names by the tribes. But according to the scriptures, this place was called Arsareth. Okay, before this damn devil touched down here. All right? Now let's jump from there to the book of Malachi. Let's see. Malachi chapter 1 and verse 3 says, "And I hated Esau, Yahawashi, Yahawashi, the heavenly father and his son, hate Esau." All right? They hate you, Edomites, and we do too. The scriptures say to love the good, all right, and hate evil. All you Edomites are evil. All you brought into the world is violence, okay? Plagues, all right? Different chaotic inventions, okay? You brought death into the world, okay? Through your envious heart, all right? Because you were rejected, okay? Although you sought it carefully with tears, you sold your birthright. And then you lied, which is evil. Lying is evil. Okay, you lied to Isaac, okay, about you selling your birthright to Jacob. Okay? Yahawashi, Yahawashi hates you Edomites, man. That's why he created you to be evil, to be wicked. All right? Although you can see what's right and what's wrong, you choose to be wrong. Okay? Because that's the spirit that the Lord designed for you to have. Okay? It says, "And laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness." Because ultimately, your habitation is going to become a waste. All right? It's going to become a wilderness. You know, what's going to cause that is nuclear missiles. All right? World War III is brewing. If you're paying attention, what's going on in the Middle East? Okay, this is the end, the beginning of the end of this damn devil Esau, the so-called white man. Okay, this is verse 4, and this is the point. It says, "Whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places." You've returned, okay, and you're starting to rebuild those desolate places that you once ruled, that you once inhabited. All right? That's where you get the term Renaissance. The word Renaissance means rebirth. And this is the rebirth of the Roman Empire. Okay? Because Esau, Edom, those were the Romans. Okay? That's the son of perdition. Okay? That's the wicked that was to be revealed. He is being revealed now. Okay, Job 9:24 says the earth was given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? Okay, this was a mystery. He was the mystery of iniquity. Okay, the mystery of all evil, of all wickedness. Okay, who's causing it? Who's influencing the minds of these people to bug the fuck out? Okay, that's none other than Esau, the so-called white man. Starting with the head tribe of Esau, Edom, who is Amalek, the so-called Jews, okay? They control everything, the media, the entertainment, the money, the resources, the militaries, the armies, okay? This man's hand was given, the earth was given into his hand, I should say, Salakia. Okay. So they have returned, because Esau, Edom was taken out of power in the late 300s, all right? You know, the Roman Empire fully took over the world, okay, after 70 AD, or I should say during 70 AD. They ransacked Jerusalem and took everything over, all right? So that's when he fully had control. And then around the late 300s, you know, Israelites, Jakes, that were still within Esau's, you know, system, revolted and took it over, okay? And was what brewed about the Byzantine Holy Roman Empire, okay? Which they were still going off, our people were still going off, but they kicked Esau off the throne. And then during the Renaissance, you know, the early to late 1400s is when these Edomites came back into rule. All right. That's where you get the term Renaissance. That's when they started to build the desolate places. Okay. And look, you know, America at one time wasn't full of cities. But now look at it. It's full of cities. Okay, there's different places in the world where Esau rules, and he's just as business as usual, just building more and more cities, more towns, more strip malls, okay, more banks, okay, because their inward thought is that they're never going to be taken down, all right? It says, thus saith Yahweh Hashem Yahawashi of hosts. Hosts means armies. They shall build, but I will throw down. So yeah, they're going to be building all these underground secret tunnel cities and other secret towns that you can't get to other than by a private road. Okay? They're going to be building. All right? You pass by towns, they're always adding on and, you know, trying to boost their economy and things of that nature. They're going to do those things. But Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi is going to destroy those towns, man. He's going to destroy those underground tunnels, man. Okay? He's going to take you out of power. All right? Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi is going to have these nations shoot missiles on you, man. Okay? You Edomites are going to shoot missiles on each other. Okay? You got the Russians. The Russians are Edomites. They're going to shoot missiles on America, on NATO, on the EU, okay? It says Togarmah is going to link up with Russia. Togarmah is Turkey, which those are Edomites as well. They're Edomites that embrace the religion of Islam, okay? But they're Edomites too, all right? And they're going to link up with Russia to go to war against America and America's allies, okay? You're going to build, but Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi is going to throw down. And they shall call them the border of wickedness, and the people against whom Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi hath indignation forever. Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi is angry with the wicked every day, okay? So Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi has a righteous fury for you Edomites. And he's going to accomplish that fury, all right, real soon, okay, by destroying your habitations, man, by giving his people power to put you in slavery. Because best believe, as the scripture says, we're going to rule our enemies with the rod of iron. It says, and we shall rule over our oppressor, okay? So we're going to receive power to put you damn Edomite devils into slavery, all right? And after those 1,000 years of hardcore bondage, we're going to eradicate your whole nation, okay? So yeah, this is a quick lesson, all right? proven how proud Esau is and showing you that eventually he's going to be destroyed. All right, so with that, all praises, honor, and glory to Yahawah by Hashem, Yahawashi, Waharakakwadash, and of course, as always, double honors to our apostles and our elders that rule well at Great Millstone. Till next time, Shalom.